Hey boys, it's HarmNone. Today we're going to be customizing the Rumpo Custom in Grand Theft Auto Online. This thing's pretty sick. I feel like it's a super underrated vehicle in this game. It's not armored, which is a big problem with it, I think, but it does only cost, I believe, $150,000. And for that price, I think it's very cool and it's very, very unique. Let's hop inside and go and customize this thing. Alright, so we're in the mod shop now. We're going to start off with the armor. Go all the way up on that, of course, for the brakes as well. And the engine, of course. Next up, we got the lights. We got the xenon headlights on there, of course. For the plate, yellow on black. For the respray, I think that the only acceptable color on this thing is a black. I know that that's not exactly a unique customization, but it does look really good, I feel like. However, I just came across stone silver, and honestly, I feel like this almost looks even better. So I'm actually going to put stone silver on this thing. Next up for the suspension, we can lower this thing. I am not going to. I like this thing raised. It's kind of an off-road vehicle, in my opinion, so we're going to leave it raised. Next up, we got the transmission all the way up, of course, and the turbo. For the wheels, we're definitely going to go for some off-roads on this thing, and I think I want to go with the concave Rallymaster. Let's do that. Let's put black rims on this. Bulletproof tires, of course. We could put a tire design on it. I don't feel like it fits very well though, so let's leave that off. And last but not least, let's do the windows all the way out. This thing is looking pretty intimidating, I feel like. Definitely not the most intimidating in the game, that's for sure. There's a lot of vehicles that are much more scary, but this thing is pretty cool, I feel like. Let's take it down to the ground, do a sound test and a quick review, and maybe even an off-road test. All right. Let's see what this thing sounds like. Usually I would give it 2 revs, but that thing sounds like a vacuum cleaner, so we're just not going to. Off the line, absolutely no wheel spin, so that's pretty good. This thing is actually remarkably fast for being a Rumpo. At the end of the day, it is a Rumpo, but that being said, it is quite a fast Rumpo. Also, without the wheel spin, it's actually very quick off the line. And the acceleration itself is actually really good, I think. This thing is very capable. The handling actually isn't too bad either so far. We're going to take it up to where we normally take these cars, and we're going to test out the handling up there. And then we are going to take it over to the canyon and do some off-roading. Okay, well that's unfortunate. That fence just got taken out. This thing does tend to go up on its two wheels a lot of the time, I find. Which, you know, isn't the end of the world, but it would be nice to be able to drive it a little bit more properly, I feel like. With that being said, the handling of it is actually pretty good. Oh my god, two wheels, boys. I saved it. Let's go. Some suspension tuning on this car would actually probably be a good idea. It doesn't lower it very much, but it probably lowers it enough to reduce the chance of flipping it over or sending it onto two wheels. But that is kind of part of the fun with this car, I feel like. Just going up on two wheels is kind of interesting, kind of puts a little bit of risk in there, kind of makes it fun. So I don't honestly mind going up on two wheels all the time, that's fine. But as you guys can see, the handling is pretty good on this thing, actually. Surprisingly, it's a lot better than I was expecting. Oh my god, two wheels again. Oh my god, okay. I feel like I'm driving like a Reliant Robin right now, but it's actually got four wheels, believe it or not. It's a pretty cool car though, guys. Like, trust me, even though it flips over all the time, it is a pretty cool car. Let's take this thing to the canyon, and we'll do an off-road test. I'll see you guys there. Alright guys, so we just got to the canyon. Let's see how this thing handles the off-road section of this test. So far, so good. It's handling these bumps pretty well, I feel like. It could have a little bit better handling, but I feel like because it's so tall, it kind of is a little bit top heavy, and that's why it kind of goes up on its wheels so much. Okay, well that's gone well. That's gone really well. Okay, nice. Finally stopped. Okay, well it does have pretty good ground clearance, so honestly it's not the worst off-roader. Let's go straight this time. Why not? I feel like it's a bit less of an off-road test on this side, but that's okay. It does eat up the bumps pretty well. It's actually really not that bad. I'm a big fan of the Rumpo Custom, to be honest. This thing's super underrated. I literally cannot remember the last time I saw somebody actually driving one of these when they weren't doing a CEO cargo mission. It's been forever, and honestly, like, I kind of get why people don't drive this, but at the same time, it's kind of just such a cool vehicle. I don't know. I'm kind of fond of the Rumpo Custom boys. I hope that I don't get roasted too hard in the comments for my appreciation of this vehicle. But you know, if I do, whatever. It's cool. I think the Rumpo is pretty sick. It's not bad for an off-roader, but I can't deny it is quite top-heavy, and it does go on two wheels way more often than I feel like it should, and way more often than I feel like is convenient, unfortunately. So that's my only gripe with the Rumpo Custom is look. Oh my god. Pretty much impossible to keep it standing on all four wheels. But with that being said, guys, for the price that it costs, which is about 130 to 150,000, I'm pretty sure it's either one of those numbers. It's not a bad vehicle. I feel like you can look past it flipping over all the time, and I feel like suspension tuning may lowering the suspension may fix some of the issue with it tipping over. So anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this customization and the review, let me know in the comments down below. Leave a like, subscribe if you guys are new, and I will see you guys in the next video. Until then, take care. Peace.